Are you an investor, a speculator, or are you looking for a family home, maybe your forever home? These are three really important things to understand and know which one you are before you start that journey of finding a home. I'm Aura Ross with the Mulholland Ross Group at realestatetoronto.com, and today I want to talk to you about the three different types of buyer you can be in the market. Now, there's probably more, but these are the three we see. And what I'm finding is that people are getting a little bit confused. Those that are looking for their forever home are starting to think like speculators and investors think like forever home buyers. So let's just kind of define the three and you can see which one you are. Maybe it'll help you make some decisions when you go out shopping for your next home. Investors are about the numbers. Okay. Investors aren't always worried about what the home's going to be worth in 10 years. What they want to know is, can they put in as little of their own money as possible? And will the property carry? Meaning, will the tenants pay for the debt load? Now, investors understand that every time that tenant makes a rent payment, it actually pays principal of the unit. So even if the investment does not go up in value, your tenant is paying equity into your loan. And at some point you will own the whole property. Or, as an investor knows as well, you can refinance against that property and use that fund to go buy your next property. This is a whole conversation which we should do a show on, just on investment. But if you are an investor, that's what you're looking for. The numbers need to make sense, and we understand that. Speculators are different. Speculators buy properties where often the numbers don't make sense. The rents don't cover off the loan. However, the buyer is speculating that the value of the property is going to go up in a pretty short period of time, where they'll be able to sell and make their profit there, right? So that's a speculator. Some of our speculators are buying real estate and redeveloping it with the plan to resell it again in hopes of making the profit there. So that's the speculator. Now, let's talk about the normal buyer. You're looking for a home. You're going to live in it. You're going to raise your children in it. You're going to spend your time there. So this is a completely different buyer. And we want you to really think about this if you're one of these buyers, because now it's about bedrooms and space and gardens and neighbors and location. Where do you want to be for the next 5, 10, 20 years? Where do you want your family to be raised if you're raising a family? You know, which driveway will make you really happy at the end of your day when you pull in your house at the end of the day and know this is your home? Now, it's not to say that as a forever home buyer, you're not caring about the value and getting good value for your money and so on, but you're not worried about the flip. You should not be worried about what it's going to be worth next year unless you plan to sell it next year. You shouldn't be worried about any of those things. This is where you're going to live. And here's the amazing thing. I don't know, after 30 years of selling real estate in the Toronto area, I don't know anyone who regrets their decision of buying a family home when it's 10, 15, 20 years later. I mean, we've all seen what our market's done in that amount of time. So these homes do become these incredible investments that allow people maybe to retire or change their lifestyle later in life. So if you are a buyer and you are one of these three people and you'd like to have this conversation a little deeper, please give us a shout. We're the Mulholland Ross Group at realestatetoronto.com. Our number's here in the email, and you can reach any of us to have a discussion at absolutely no obligation. Just be sure you're not confusing things, because you might not end up with the property you really wanted. Again, I'm Aura with Mulholland Ross Group. We'll see you in the neighborhood.